Let's walk through and pick the queue on which to place TY based on the scheduling policy. Now, if you ask the question, what is the minimum I plus Q for PU for this particular thread TY, that's going to be the affinity that TY has on PU. The affinity that TY has on PU is 2. But also, we have to look at the queue size. And the queue size of PU is 1. There's only one thread sitting there. So the overall min of I plus Q for TY with respect to PU is 3. Let's do the same thing for TY on PV. In the case of PV, its affinity apparently is higher because there's only one intervening task that ran since the last time TY ran on it. That's good news. But we also have to look at the queue of PV. When TY gets put on PV's queue, it has to sit behind whatever they may be already. And in the case of PV, the queue already has 4 threads to run. So when TY is put on PV's queue, it's going to be stuck at the end of this queue, which means that in a sense, the amount of intervention that is going to happen for TY on PV by the time it gets to run is actually the size of the affinity index for TY with respect to PV currently, as well as the intervention that's going to happen by the time it actually gets to run. So that's 4. So the overall I plus Q is 5 for this guy and 3 for this guy, which means that the choice I'm going to make is to put TY on PU because that's the one that will result in the least amount of intervention for polluting the cache of PU with respect to this particular thread TY.